Hello everyone, thank you for joining me. 大家好，我是兰迪老师。咱们在五十五课啊，通过观察 Sawyer Family 的日常生活，学习了频率副词 always、usual 的用法。同学们估计还没有完全消化吧？咱们今天就来强化练习一下。你会听到啊，类似这样的问题 ：What does he always do in the morning？ 你要根据图片的指令呢，做出回答。咱们直接进入实践练习时间，让我们开始本节课的 repetition drill。
Lesson 56, Repetition Drill. Look at the first picture. What does she often do in the morning?
She often dusts the cupboard in the morning.
Look at the second picture. What does she always do in the morning?
She always makes the bed in the morning.
Look at the third picture. What does he always do in the morning?
He always shaves in the morning.
Look at the fourth picture. What do they sometimes do in the evening?
They sometimes listen to the stereo in the evening.
Look at the 21st picture. What does he always do every day?
He always cleans the blackboard every day.
Look at the 22nd picture. What do they always do at night?
They always go to bed at night.
Look at the 23rd picture. What does she usually do every day?
She usually washes the dishes every day.
Look at the 24th picture. What do they usually do in the afternoon?
They usually type letters in the afternoon.
Look at the 31st picture. What does the cat usually do every day?
It usually drinks milk every day.
Look at the 32nd picture. What do they sometimes do in the evening?
They sometimes watch television in the evening.
Look at the 33rd picture. What does she always do at noon?
She always eats her lunch at noon.
Look at the 34th picture. What does he often do in the evening?
He often reads his newspaper in the evening.
Look at the first picture. What does she often do in the morning?
She often dusts the cupboard in the morning.
Look at the second picture. What does she always do in the morning?
She always makes the bed in the morning.
Look at the third picture. What does he always do in the morning?
He always shaves in the morning.
Look at the fourth picture. What do they sometimes do in the evening?
They sometimes listen to the stereo in the evening.
Look at the 21st picture. What does he always do every day?
He always cleans the blackboard every day.
Look at the 22nd picture. What do they always do at night?
They always go to bed at night.
Look at the 23rd picture. What does she usually do every day?
She usually washes the dishes every day.
Look at the 24th picture. What do they usually do in the afternoon?
They usually type letters in the afternoon.
Look at the 31st picture. What does the cat usually do every day?
It usually drinks milk every day.
Look at the 32nd picture. What do they sometimes do in the evening?
They sometimes watch television in the evening.
Look at the 33rd picture. What does she always do at noon?
She always eats her lunch at noon.
Look at the 34th picture. What does he often do in the evening?
He often reads his newspaper in the evening.
在本节课里我们将学到如下的内容。首先在词法方面，我们要学会吃早饭、午饭、晚饭怎么表达呢？分别是 breakfast, lunch, or brunch, 还有 dinner 的两种用法。在句法里面，我们第一要复习频率副词在句子当中出现的位置，第二呢，还要复习表示时间的短语它在句子里面出现的位置，第三还要学会询问别人你的日常安排是什么呀？ What do you usually do? 咱们本节课啊，没有生词的负担，直接进入词法环节，来学一下吃早午晚饭怎么表达。首先，那我们吃早饭 have 或者是 eat my breakfast。Eat my lunch 是吃午饭，那还有一个表达叫 have my lunch， 是指的是一样的。这个 my 呢，是指我吃午饭。那如果只是说吃午饭，你可以直接说 eat lunch 或者是 have lunch。现代更简洁的表达，直接用 have 比较多一点。我们来看一下吃晚饭。如果咱们想用最简洁的方式来表达吃晚饭，直接说 have dinner。作为晚饭 dinner 还有一种表达叫 supper。它其实两个是一样的，只是用法习惯不同。语法书上会讲 dinner 稍微正式一点， supper 就是个简单的晚餐，但是 dinner 这个概念现在已经越来越普及化了。看最后一个单词叫 brunch， 这是什么意思？什么叫早午饭？我们通常早餐就是六点到八点左右，哎，吃完去上班。但是在周末呢，有的人就起得特别晚，早餐和午餐就连到一起了。 Landy 在瑞士上学的时候，我们学校周末提供的饭就叫 brunch， 它从早上九点开始到下午两点结束。那这个 brunch 的构词啊，它也很直白，就是把 breakfast 前两个字母摘过来，是早餐的意思，再把 lunch 后面的四个字母再摘过来拼到一起，叫早午饭。Have brunch 或者是 eat brunch， 以上就是各种吃饭的表达。接下来我们进入到今天的句法环节，首先快速复习一下频率副词的位置。频率副词在句子当中啊，一般跟我们的中文的位置很像，比如说他经常，那就是 he often， 他总是 she is always。 但有的同学分不清了，有时候在动词前面还是动词后面，我们记住一个小小的规律，实义动词前be 动词后 ，she is always happy。be 动词后面 ，she always is happy。这样听上去怪怪的啊。好了，记住它在 be 动词的后面，实义动词的前面。我们来看一下例句啊。He often goes to bed at 10。他经常在十点钟睡觉。She is always happy。他总是很快乐。学习完了频率副词，那跟它紧接着会同时出现的就叫时间短语。那一般呢，时间短语都在句子的末尾。 在语法书上啊，它叫时间状语。其实很多同学一听到主谓宾定状补就头疼。其实当你知道只要跟时间有关，就在句子的末尾，可能同学们反倒觉得学得轻松一点啊。我管它叫时间短语。好了，在早上、下午、晚上，咱们快速复习一下 in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening。 在正午 at noon, at midday， 这两个都是表示在正午，中午12点。那在晚上呢 at night。 那还有一种表示规律的，每一天、每一周、每一年， every day, every week， 还有 every year。 时间短语一般情况下都出现在句子的尾巴上。 He walks to school every day。 在英文的表达上，通常呢表示时间的都放在句子的尾巴上，因为英文总是有这样一个习惯叫重点先行。他每天步行去上学，那他其实是想强调步行上学，所以他先说 He walks to school every day， 然后他步行去上学。什么时候步行？每一天步行上学。 I often watch TV at night。 我看电视，我什么时候看电视啊？ Oh, at night， 晚上看。 They go to school at 7 in the morning。 他们早上7点去上学。还是去上学这件事情是最重要的，是动作。然后什么时候做的？哦，早上去上学。那学习了频率副词，学习了时间，你自然就能学会如何询问别人的日常安排了。 What do you usually do in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, at night? 你每一天从早到晚你都是怎么安排的呀？以上就是本节课的所有内容，咱们快速做一个小结。首先在词法方面，我们学习了吃饭除了用 eat， 那现在更常见的叫 have。 那除了早中晚饭之外，我们还学了一个早晚饭。你知道这个词是怎么产生的吗？叫 brunch。 bra 是早餐 breakfast 前两个字母， unch 是 lunch 的后四个字母，组合在一起叫 brunch， 就是指从早上一直吃到下午。这个 brunch 是不是有点像广东人喝的早茶呀？他们从早上7-8点开始喝，一直喝到下午。 OK， 这是词法。在句法里面我们复习了频率副词还有时间短语在句子里面的用法。我们在句法的最后一个部分学到了一个非常有用的结构，去问别人一天当中的日程安排。比如说 What do you usually do in the morning？ 你早上通常干嘛？那这个 in the morning 是早上，那可不可以替换成下午和晚上？都是可以的，只要结构相同，换时间就好了。以上就是本节课的全部知识点了，现在是时候测试一下咱们的收获咯。以考代练，咱们最终是要实现提升能力，顺便考试。我给你准备了5道选择题，你可以暂停一下视频，看看自己能否全部做对。好了，我们来看第一题。 Number one， Mrs. Smith does theEvery day， 她做啥呀？每一天。Oh, she cleans and cooks， 她又打扫还有煮饭，这个属于 housework， 好，家务啊，所以 C 选项正确。 Number two， 第二题。 Tina has 4 lessons morning， no lessons afternoon。 Oh， 是想问我们的时间介词对吧？那在早上肯定是 in the morning， 选项里 A 和 C 是正确的。 No lessonsNoon 是中午，要用 at， 所以直接把 A 选项排除掉了，选 C。 我们来保险一下，看完最后一个句子， 2 lessons afternoon， 所以是 in， C 选项正确。我们来看第三题。 Number 3， Jack usually 空格 TV in the evening。 你肯定反应过来了，这里考你的是三单，因为是 Jack 是第三人称单数。我们找到了 C 和 D 正确啊，那还有第二句， But he is a book now. He is a book. 说不看电视了。哦，原来在看书啊。这里说的是正在看书， is 后面要加动词的 ing， 这里叫现在进行时的结构，叫 be doing， 所以用 reading， D 选项正确。 Number 4， 第四题。 My father will arriveLondon tomorrow morning. Arrive 到达某个地方，大地点用 in， 小地点用 at。 London 是一个城市，很大，所以用 D 选项。来，我们看第五题，最后一题 ，Number five， the 空格 often go to the park together。好了，我们看到选项里面啊是 Brown， 是指的是布朗一家，那指某一个家庭呢？我们有两种表达，第一种叫 the Brown family， 这个里面是没有 s 的。但如果你把 family 拿掉呢，我直接在 Brown 后面加个 s， 那选项里面只有 B 是正确的。我是兰迪老师，我们下节课再见吧。See you next time. Bye for now.